It says here, we have to wear hats that protect our heads when our tour guide takes us camping.
So?
Well, it doesn't say what kind of hats.
Well, I don't think this beanie would be much good. It keeps my head warm, but it wouldn't protect it from bumps.
It just won't do. And I don't think this hat would be any good for caving. People wear different things on their heads in all kinds of situations. What sorts of things do you wear on your head? And why do you wear them? Perhaps Dodley's hat will look like the hard hats these underground adventurers are wearing. The torches are helping them to see where they're going, while their hands are free to hold on to things. Can you think of some other people who wear hard hats to protect their heads? Bike riders who compete in races wear helmets made in a special shape called a streamlined shape. It's a shape that helps the cyclist to cut through the rushing air, making it easier to ride fast. Some protective headgear has a shield attached to the front to protect faces, especially eyes. Face shields worn by welders often have a hard, clear window to see through. Sports people sometimes wear headgear with face shields too. These shields are made from strong mesh that protects their faces while letting in lots of fresh air. People who work in places where lots of food is prepared often wear protective headgear too. But these paper caps aren't to protect their heads. Instead, they're worn to protect food. No one wants to find hairs in their meal. Of course, people had to work out designs for all this headgear before it was made. To come up with the right design, they had to think about who would wear the headgear, and when, where, and why they would wear it.
So if you make a really big brim, comes out wide, it'll cover your ears.
Bob and Carol are designing a new sun hat.
The flap will be just to cover the back of your neck, so it doesn't have to come right in close to your face.
It's for people to wear when they play golf.
Make that back like a loop, like the back of a cat.
Still have the
pink, purple of that.
Yep, that's right.
And
what about make these sides, the panel there, something that breathes where the breeze goes through. Does it feel nice and cool?
Okay. Yeah, maybe some mesh in there. She don't need that to sort of fit itself. Just there.
Carol's made a trial hat to test their design ideas. The wide brim and neck flap are good protection from the sun, and the cord makes it easy to change the size. Bob's using a computer to draw the final design. Once everyone's happy with the design, it's time to start making. Different parts of this hat will be made from different materials. The stiff brim will be made from cotton, nylon, and foam, all stuck together. These are some of the different cutters that are used to cut the material into the right shapes. This machine works just like a biscuit cutter. This is much quicker than using scissors to cut out all the different shapes. Next, all the pieces are stitched together using strong cotton thread. It's a bit like putting a jigsaw together. Bob and Carol must have got their design right. The orders are already coming in.
We always wear sun hats when we're outside so that our faces and necks don't get sunburned. Having so many hats that look the same can make it hard to work out whose is whose. That's why we're making our own sun hats. Mine's going to be like the one Mrs. Kurtz wears.
What are you going to do with them?
What kind of hat is good to wear when you're out in the sun?
A good sun hat stops your nose and ears from getting sunburned. It needs to cover your neck too. A sun hat shouldn't be too heavy and thick, or be too hot to wear.
A sun hat's supposed to block out the sun. So do you think it could be made from these materials? What about these?
First it was supposed to be like that, and then it flipped down like that.
So then I cut two holes and put these something in a circle.
Why are you putting these bits of coloured paper on it?
To stop the bugs coming
out. How do you make sure your hat's the right size and shape for your head? Well, you could use a measuring tape. Or you could just use a strip of cardboard or a piece of string to work out how big your hat needs to be. You might have to have another think about your design if something's not quite working.
Feels hard enough to protect my head from bumps and bruises, and oh yes, the torch works really well, so we'll be able to see where we're going without having to hold a torch in our hands. And yep, there's room enough underneath for snacks to munch on as we're crawling along. And this should keep it from falling off. What do you think of our new hat?
It's bright, Dudley.
Oh, yeah, sorry, Finn. And it's really hard.
Dudley, we can't go.
What?
I'm sorry, Dudley, but the tour's been cancelled.
But why?
Because the cave entrance has iced over. You can't get in.
Well, that's just great.
But don't worry, Dudley. I've booked us on a different adventure holiday.
What kind of adventure holiday?
Well, it's been snowing so much, we're going to...
What, Flynn? What?
I thought we could go snowboarding.
Snowboarding? Wow! Oh, no. I don't suppose I'll be needing this.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dudley.
No, it's not your fault, Flynn. Just wondering...
What?
Well, I'm wondering, what should we wear on our heads when we go snowboarding? It would have to be something hard, so we don't hurt ourselves if we were to fall over.
Yeah, and warm.
Flynn! Oh, you left the door open, Flynn!
Yeah, it's still snowing outside, too.
Then contact ABC Commercial on 1-300-650-587 or visit abc.net.au/programsales.